New on 7, a New Mexico man had pieces of his Native American heritage stolen from him last weekend in Albuquerque after attending a powwow at the Black Mesa Casino.
When you're the person that loses these things in your mind, you're thinking, I'm not getting nothing back. I have to say goodbye, you know, but somewhere deep in the back of the mind, deep in the pit of my heart, still saying, hopefully, hopefully.
But then he got a call from his sister.
Action 7 News reporter John Cardinelli shares the emotional reunion between a man and his priceless possessions.
A journey, and that's exactly what it's been.
For Ashkia Trujillo, the last few days have been a quest to find his stolen cultural treasures.
So I was on my way to Grant's when I, you know, somebody wanted to give some help and, you know, pass out flyers there. And when I turned around, you know, it was because I got that phone call.
Ashkia receiving that call from his sister Micah, saying the items had been returned to her after one of the coordinators for the Black Mesa powwow got a call from someone who said they bought the items on the street for $400.
And the reason why the guy said he wanted to buy it was because his mother collects Native American regalia and he wanted to give it to her to have. But when he found out that it was stolen, then that's when he wanted to return it.
The regalia with deep family roots.
And so these were created in 1940 something.
Now sitting in Ashkia's living room once again, but some of the items are not in their original condition.
What really hurt me was whoever took this, you know, broke my son's bustle. And it really bothers me, you know. I put a lot of time into making this bustle, and this piece here was created by my father years ago when I was a little kid.
And some of them still missing.
You know, we don't have the turquoise and silver jewelry, but, you know, those things can also be replaced.
But most of the irreplaceable heirlooms were returned.
For me, it was definitely something that you would call a miracle.
On a journey, Ashkia says, was filled with determination, hope, and support.
Just do what you can so at the end of the day, Creator can see that you're trying your best no matter what. And I see a lot of our Native people struggling out there. It hurts me to see that. But, you know, everyone gave me prayers and sent good vibes and did a lot. That's how all of this came back. So with that, you know, just know that those prayers mean a lot to me and to my family.
I'm John Cardinelli reporting, KOAT Action 7 News.
Trujillo says he's going to work on restoring the damaged items so he and his children can dance in them once again. He's a part of the Okeowenge Pueblo.